The next phase of stopping the spread of the coronavirus relies heavily on contact tracing. Tech says they can help with that, but can it be done in a way without infringing on people's privacy? Hey everyone, welcome back to Today in Tech. I'm Juliet Beauchamp. Before I tell you how exactly tech is saying they can solve the issue of contact tracing, let's first talk about what exactly it is. It's kind of exactly what it sounds like. It traces the people you have come into contact with if you contract the coronavirus. This can be really helpful in alerting people who are maybe asymptomatic or showing mild symptoms that they have come into contact with someone with the coronavirus and should get tested immediately. If they get tested, they can quarantine until they get their results, and if their results are then positive, that means that they can stay home and prevent the spread to other people. This could be especially helpful for people who are asymptomatic, like I said, who may still be running their essential errands and interacting with some people every day or every few days. Or even these essential workers, the people who work in grocery stores, in pharmacies, who are still talking and interacting with a lot of people every day, it could be really important for them to know that they have come into contact with someone who has it so they can then stay home until they're either cleared through a test or until they ride the virus out and they don't spread it to anyone else. There's two main ways to approach the issue of contact tracing. There's the high-tech way with an app, and there's the old-fashioned way, which pretty much just involves calling someone on the phone. This old-fashioned way of calling people that may have come into contact with you if you become infected with the coronavirus would look a little something like this. So if I become infected, I tell my state health department, my doctor, a third-party program, they reach out to everyone that I may have come into contact with. This could pose some issues because it only assumes about 10 contacts per person, and there's always the issue of me not being able to recall exactly who I interacted with. But the good thing is that there's that person-to-person interaction, which could be especially comforting and helpful for people right now. And then, of course, there's the higher tech version of contact tracing, which would involve some sort of application. Apple and Google are actually collaborating right now to develop an app that would allow people who have contracted the coronavirus to self-diagnose, and anyone that they may have come into contact with would be alerted on their phone. This actually involves Bluetooth pings rather than GPS data. So anytime that my phone came into contact with your phone, if we were close enough for our phones to talk to each other using Bluetooth, if I got the coronavirus and I self-reported on the app, you'd get a notification that you've come into contact with someone who has it. Of course, as with many big tech solutions, people are still going to be really worried about their privacy, especially when it comes to really intimate details like your health record. But Apple and Google are assuring people that their app is going to make privacy of utmost importance. And here's how. First and foremost, you will have to consent to using the app, and it'll be explicit this is how your data is being used. Instead of using GPS data, say I go to the grocery store on Monday at 12:50, that information's not really going to be that important. What is going to be important is if I have the app and others around me have the app, that our phones are talking to each other. It'll work a little like this. I'm carrying my phone with me, of course, when I'm going to the grocery store or to the pharmacy or potentially work if I still need to be in the office. And my phone will be equipped with this app. This app is always talking to other phones through Bluetooth pings. So instead of getting a notification that, you know, Juliet was at the grocery store and you were also there, it'll look more that I've self-reported and hey, you've come into contact with my phone somewhere, so you should go get tested. And these Bluetooth pings are randomly generated identifiers that makes it really hard to tell you from any other data on your phone. So hopefully it'll keep all of your data and personal information anonymous. All communication will also be done on your device, so no information is going to one centralized location. You also cannot be forced to download this app, and your explicit consent to gather this data will be required. Apple and Google are also saying that in an effort that this privilege is not abused, this app will be shut down once the pandemic is over, possibly area by area, and it will only be allowed to be used by public health officials and providers and governments. So I want to know your thoughts. Would you be willing to download this kind of app, or would Apple and Google need to take additional steps to protect your privacy for you to be willing to download it? Let me know in the comments below. And thanks so much for watching this episode of Today in Tech. If you liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.